What is it with men and the obsession with anal?
Yeah.
And I'm guessing the implication, like, we're talking about straight men for the most part in this question, I would say.
Yeah, I think we're, like, safely assuming here that this person themselves isn't a man when they're wondering, like, what is it with these men?
Yeah, with these men over here. Men.
In 2021, Pornhub did a survey and it was the 8th most searched term. So, like, it's not...
And 6th most viewed. I actually thought that would be higher.
Yeah.
But that's, I mean, it's still high. Top 10 is... But yeah, I did think it's not uncommon. Absolutely, you're not imagining things. We've talked about butt stuff a bit on Horny on Main. We've, like, gone into rimming and a lot of the time we, you know... The answer, as long as everyone's like fully enthusiastic and exploring carefully and all of those things to most questions, is like go for it, like fun.
Yeah.
But I can understand if this person that's written into us, like if they're with a sexual partner or sexual partners who just keep asking and keep asking and keep asking when they're not that into it, like I can understand why you might not want to like hear from a man full stop for another few years or whatever. So if we're breaking down like part of the like what is the obsession, so yes, like it's a thing of the times and things are becoming less hush hush that maybe were once, but also like part of this answer, even if it's depending on the person, not much of it, like at least part of it is their butts are hot.
Yeah,
like butts are juicy, butts are hot, like that's part of why men might be obsessed with anal sex, is like, oh, new thing to explore, butts are hot.
It's another part of your body that your partners can engage with that is also like hidden, you know, your other genitalia. And, you know, I think it's like so obvious to say, but butts have that kind of like inbuilt, like, oh, this is wrong, because the biological function of people's buttholes is, you know, to poo. So poop comes out of it. So it has this like anal straddles this world of being both now kind of on the table, not seen as like a really like rude or disrespectful thing to bring up, but it still has that like, maybe shouldn't be doing this.
Yeah, like look at us go.
Yeah, this is risky or...
We talk a lot about how sexual norms can become coercive, or I think about it a lot because I think back in when I was more casually sexually active, I, you know, went along with things because it was what was expected. It can be much more subliminal than that. It can be much more feeling like, you know, you are aboard the sex train, destination anal town, and there's nothing you can do about it, you know. But actually, that's not real. Like your sex train is going to like wherever you want to go to. An anal town is like a little side loop that you can choose to take if you want to. It's not an inevitability.
Yeah, and I think like a lot of people's concern comes from like younger people engaging.
That's where my concern comes in.
Where like maybe like you said, the train, they don't know that they're in control of their train. They might end up putting a lot of like, this person's the train driver of my train.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, with anal, there seems to be like this horrible ghost hanging around from the past of like, someone's no can become a yes if you keep asking. And, you know, I think when I hear the word obsession, maybe this person might have had experiences like that where they can't seem to let it go. Like, if I don't want to do it, that's the end of the conversation.
Yeah, totally.
I think also with these conversations, you just hit them with the, and what about you?
You know, what about your butt?
Yeah, what about your butt? If they're so interested in engaging in these sorts of play and these forms of sex, like, if they're more than happy to keep pestering you and are super dismissive of the idea that you could also be enjoying their butt, like, again, red flag, absolute no-go.
And in the wake of our conversation that we had before this series about pegging, I had a couple of, I think cis dudes get in touch and be like, exploring being pegged was amazing for my relationship with my girlfriend, just for how I got to experience that feeling and was so much more empathetic about what anal sex requires when it's like flipped.
Yeah,
like if you're that into it, like give it a go yourself maybe, and then
exactly
and then we can talk.